Hello friends, myself Dilip Chaturvedi and I would like to welcome for this PMP introduction session. So, what is the agenda for today's session? Know more about a PMP training program offered from the Just PMP. Know your presentator and what is the PMI and PMP certification? Prerequisite for a PMP certification. What are the project management experience and education means for a PMP certification? PMP examination pattern. How to apply for PMP certification online and what are the key features of a PMP exam pre-preparation training provided by the Just PMP and how to register for this course. How it works, how this Just PMP provide training. So we are basically provide a instructor led live online PMP training. So it is a live online classes will be there and we'll be conducting through the audio and audio calls and web conferencing, and we are basically provide PMP notes based on the latest changes of a PMP examination syllabus after the 11th Jan 2016, and what are the changes has been done it. So we'll cover all those changes during our training. We provide a 35 contact hour certificate, which is a mandatory for a PMP certification exam. We assist you in filing a PMP application form. Module-wise quizzes will going to provide you two full-length mock PMP practice test, most important for evaluation purpose, and we provide a 24/7 on-demand support. And if you need any after a course is completed, you need any support, we also provide it. An access of our free resources such as one-liner PMP notes, short PMP notes, mind map diagram. So all these are free to our students. Know your presentator for this session. Myself Dilip Chaturvedi, I am a PMP certified professional and I have a more than 10 years of experience in IT consulting and training experience across a range of verticals and technologies. I conduct various in-house PMP training for a lot of MNCs companies and train more than 50 students for a PMP training, and I have experience. I have a project ERP implementation projects experience in the different segments like engineering, media information, energy and utilities, and real estate and retail. What is a PMI? And project management, PMI is basically stand for the Project Management Institutes, and it is a not-for-profit association. It is a not-for-profit association and it was established in 1969. It's a global organization headquartered in Pennsylvania. It's in US based, they have a headquarters in the US, and over 650,000 members worldwide over 171 countries. And PMI is basically actively engaged in advocacy for a profession, setting a professional standards, conducting research and providing access to the wealth of information and resources. PMI also promotes a career and professional development and offers a certification, networking and community involvement opportunities. What is a PMP certification? PMP certification is basically conducted by the PMI, and the PMI offers this non-profit organization. Basically, they offer this PMP certification for a project management professional. And PMI, as a stand for a project management professional, this certification is offered and conducted by PMI. Project Management Institute is the world's leading not-for-profit professional membership association for a project, program, and portfolio management profession. Founded in 1969, and PMI delivers a value for more than 2.9 billion professionals working nearly every country in the world through the global advocacy, collaboration, education, and research. More than 650,000 professionals across the industry vertical have chosen a PMP certification to get a global recognition from their project management. And there's one survey was there, and they basically, those who are PMP certified professionals, they earn up to 25% more than non-certified professional. This is really important. After you complete your PMP certification, you can look for a different opportunities within your organization, outside organizations. PMI certification holders gains increased recognition from their peers for taking an extra step in the professional development. It's the most respected project management certification across all the industry in the world. So very important. What is the prerequisite for PMP certification? So there are the two options are there. And if you are a 4-year degree holders, for example, you are a, you have a bachelor's degree like a, you know, engineering and some 4 years of that education. And then in that case, you should have at least 3 years of project management experience or a minimum of, 4,500 hours leading and directing projects. And you should have gone for, 35 hours of project management training. So this is where the Just PMP will going to help you. We're going to train you. We're going to give you training. And we after the training is completed, we're going to give you 35 hours of project management education certificate. That's what we called as a contact hour certificate. So there is an option another option is there, and this is for a secondary degree holders, like those who have a high school diploma or associate degree, sometimes those who are work in a construction or some other segment where they have not gone for a 4-year degree holder, they have secondary degree holders. For them also the PMI offers a PMP certification, but they should have at least 5 years of a project management experience or a minimum of 7,500 hours of leading and directing our projects. Have required 35 hours of project management education. Again, for them, same thing. You should have gone for a 35 hours of project management training. The important points, project duration must not overlap. For example, if you're working on a multiple projects, those whatever the number of hours you have worked on there, so that will be counted as part of 4,500 hours or 7,500. That all depend upon your education. Designation during a specified project management work does not matter. So this is one more important. It is not important you should be a project manager only, then you can go for PMP certification. No, but you should be working. You should be involved into the initiation, planning, execution, monitoring and controlling. So these are the areas if you have worked on it, so that experience will be counted. So we're going to cover on the next slide. 10% of application are picked for a random audit. So this is when you fill the application form, so it basically go for an approval. And so it has been observed that almost 10% of application they are picked for random audit. So this is randomly they picked up and they basically audit what are the detail that you have filled in the your application form. They will ask you the certificate of that. So those things, make sure that you should prepare for that. And we're going to help you if you as a part of the student, we're going to help you in that. What are the details and what certificate when you're filling your project management experience, basically you should speak to your supervisor and make sure that he should be aware about it, your experience for the project where you worked on it. And for a 35 contact hour certificate, after training is completed, we're going to provide you 35 contact hour certificate. What is a project manager's experience and education means? This is an important point. In this case, there's no need to carry job title as a project manager, which I have already explained you. Like, there's no need of if you have a title as a project manager, then you can go for PMP certification. No, that's not a mandatory, but must be assigned the responsibility of managing and taking care of the project. So you'll be responsible for managing and taking care of the project. So that experience will be counted. Experience is about a project management. So this experience that that you are going to mention in as part of your project management experience during application. So that experience is about a project management, not just carrying out a project works managed by the others. So somebody is already managing a project and he is taking care of all the things, and that experience will not be counted. So the experience where you have been involved into that, you will be managing the project. Must have an experience in all the life cycle phases of the project. So the five process groups of our project management lifecycle, including initiation, planning, directing, monitoring, and controlling the project works. PMI does not require to have an experience from the five process groups for every project. That means you can just involve into the initiating in the project A, closing in the project B, and all three others in the project C. So what basically it means that, you know, you have been working the multiple projects. So maybe in one project we have been part of execution, and maybe in another project we've been part of the closing. You will be involved into the closing of the project or planning of the project. So it means that those experience in those process group that will be counted. So but you should work, you should have experience in all the process group. So that is the most important part. What is the project management education as recognized by the PMI? So as I mentioned, 35 contact hour certificate. So PMI will going to consider education, your training from the below things. One is from training companies or consultant. So when you talk about a training companies or consultant, here just PMP is a, for example, like a just PMP, the way we are. So we are basically training companies and we provide, you know, the PMP. We are eligible and we are certified, you know, we are eligible from the PMI, as per the PMI, to provide a PMP certification training. Our distance learning companies, including end of course assessment, so those that is also they can also provide that those who are providing those things, so that experience will be education will be counted. University and college academic and continuing education program, employer and company sponsored program. Sometimes within you know the MNC company, they conduct this education, this PMP, so that will be experiences also be counted. So PMI registered education provider and PMI chapters and companies. So these are the things that PMI will going to consider. So the most important is a training company or consultant. So that's something, one thing. Following education does not satisfy the education requirement. That is a PMI chapter meeting. Sometimes, you know, different area wise, there's a chapter, you know, they have been created. And so basically those chapter will be the, you know, the PMP professional will going to meet and discuss about what is the current standards are going, any new things are there. So those are the chapter meetings. If you are involved into that chapter meetings, just 1 or 2 hour, so that education is not, that will not be considered as part of the education. If you are doing a self-directed learning, that is also not be considered. So it is a compulsory, you should have a minimum 35 hours of training. PMP examination pattern. So it is a computer-based exam conducted in the Pro Matrix Center. 200 multiple choice question mixed randomly across a process group to be answered in the 4 hours. So 4 hours is there. Out of 200 question, 175 are final marking and remaining 25 are pre-test question. So out of 200, 175 is the for basically for final marking. So remaining 25 are pre-test question and they can randomly can come anywhere. So you don't know it, so you have to focus on all the 200 question. There is no negative marking in the exam, and that's a good thing. So no negative marking, you should attempt all the 200 questions. Examination developed by the group of individuals around the globe who holds the PMP credential, and after the clearing exam you will get the results on immediate basis that you have been you have cleared the examination. And if you failed, so they will give you that results. And after you pass the you know, examination, the PMP certificate will come by mail within 3 weeks. Apply for a PMP certification online. So you can apply for PMP exam through the online system. So certificate.pmi.org, you can go and fill up the form. And information entered the form will be stored up to the 90 days. So whatever the information that will be stored as a draft, so that will be for up to the 90 days. So within 90 days, will fill and submit. If after 90 days you will not complete on something, so basically that you need to start from the scratch again. Optional but highly recommended, become a member of a PMI. So here PMI annual membership is 129 plus 10% of first time registration. So, and that's a good thing. If you are PMI membership, you have an access, you can download free PDF copy of PMBOK guide fifth edition, and so that is a latest edition, whatever is there. So that is a freely available after you doing after being a membership of that, and with that membership you will get also discount in the, you know, your certification fees. So now if you are being a membership, you need to just pay 405, that is a $405 dollar for members, and if you're non-member, you need to pay $550. So still, you know, here being a membership and you are still saving $10, almost $10 to $15. So this is good, you know, being a membership of that. Selected randomly by PMI for you know, unfortunately you fill the form and something, you know, you were selected. So as mentioned, this is randomly selected by PMI. So in that case, you know, you basically, they will give you the notification email and they will ask you what are the details that you need to send them. So, and you need to just provide those details. If everything is good, they will immediately confirm you that your application is approved. Go ahead and schedule the exam. So after the application is approved, you'll have basically 1 year. Within 1 year, you need to schedule your examination. So application submission, as I mentioned, you have 90 days to complete the application once you have started. And, you know, as soon as you fill the form, so application completeness review. So when submitted online, so they take a 5 days to review it. And if, you know, and within that, you know, as soon as when you submit it also, that time you need to basically pay the fees. And so in that case, you know, whatever, if you are PMI membership, you need to pay 405 or non 550. So after the you done a payment, so they will audit your application and they will say you yes, yeah, no. So if they ask you some document, you need to submit those documents. And if application is approved, everything, so within 1 year you need to appear for examination. And from date of approval, that will be from where 1 year, within 1 year you need to go for basically examination. And you can take a exam up to 3 times during 1 year. There is a certification cycle. So basically your certification cycle begins the day when you pass the exam. And so as soon as when the you pass the examination, that's where your PMP certification cycle begins, and you need to maintain. So that's the one thing that credential maintenance. So you are required to earn and report 60 professional development unit, that's called as a PDOs, within a 3 year cycle. So you know, within a 3 years you need to earn 60 PDOs. So that's not a complicated where you can you know, earn those things. So basically you need to again go through the different training, PMI chapter meetings or training conducted by organizations. So just like a Just PMP conducted training, so we after training will going to give you the PDs. So 1 hour training is basically one PDU. So that's and the reason why they have PMI have done it, so the all the project management professionals, they are up to date what latest changes are going on. So this is what they're trying to do it. So within, you know, 3 years, you need to have 60 PDUs. So automatically, you you know, you can just pay the renewal fees and that continue on that. If you don't pay it, so your credential is going to expire, you know, suspension for 1 year period. So these are the processes that will going to be taken care of after you clear a PMP certification exam. Key features of a PMP training provided by the Just PMP. As a PMBOK guide, fifth, focus training by the faculty with the 10 years of industry experience and PMP certified professional, and methodology which ensures 100% pass rate. So post training mentoring till you pass examination beyond. So that's the most important part. As soon as after training is over, so again we're going to provide you support, what the support that you need it, and if you need any refreshment class, so that we also conduct it based on the student case to case. And we also give you the free 2 mock tests, and so that will be for evaluation purpose. This is very similar to the PMP practice test, and if we you know, we are also going to see your report of this mock test, and we'll recommend based on your report, based on your performance, we'll suggest you whether you like to go for examination or you want to again go and prepare something. And wherever you have a doubt, we'll again going to sit with you and clear those doubts. We're going to provide a PMP notes, we're going to provide one-liners, short notes, mind map diagram, and we're going to help you and give you tips for PMP exam. So these are the features that you know the of our PMP training course. How to register for PMP training? It's basically you need to go to our justpmp.com/training schedule. So here you will get a latest update of our PMP training schedule and payment option offered by the Just PMP. So it's basically we have a different option, so you can go through it and you can pay online. For free PMP training videos, subscribe our YouTube channel. So that's youtube.com/c.justpmp.com. So here you'll get a free training PMP videos. For free 2 full length of PMP practice test, sign up to our website. We're going to provide a credential for free PMP practice test. PMP notes that you can download from the from our Just PMP website, and this is totally free. Connect us for latest update on PMP examination on our Facebook page. So just like us and just join connect them on the Just Facebook page for any latest update on a PMP certification. Follow us on Twitter. We are also on the Twitter. Just follow on. Thank you very much for this session, and if you have any need any assistance, you can reach out to us at info@justpmp.com, and visit for any PMP training program, any pre-preparation training, you can contact us, visit us at justpmp.com. Please like us and subscribe, click on subscribe button to get an update for latest pre-PMP training videos. Thank you very much.